October 1909, the National Training School for Women and Girls opens its doors. The school teaches job training skills to African American women. One woman is responsible for its creation. Educator, religious leader, and social activist, Nannie Helen Burroughs. Nannie Helen Burroughs was born to two former slaves in Orange, Virginia. Her father died when she was young. Her mother moved them to Washington, D.C., where there were more opportunities and better education for people of color. Burroughs graduated with honors from Washington's Colored High School, which was then the nation's best school for black youth. She learned under prominent mentors, including Dr. Anna Julia Cooper and Mary Church Terrell. But despite her academic achievements, Burroughs had trouble getting a teaching job, almost certainly because of her skin color. So she decided to open her own school. She wanted a curriculum for women that focused on both education and job training. She raised money from within the black community, and the National Baptist Convention purchased land for the school in Northeast DC. In October of 1909, the National Training School for Women and Girls officially opened with 35 students. Classes ranged from dressmaking, handicrafts and music, to power machine operation, public speaking, and physical education. Nannie Helen Burroughs never married and devoted her life to educating and advocating for black women until her death in 1961. In 1964, her school was renamed in her honor. The building represents Burroughs' legacy as a pioneer for African American women's rights and a testament to her lifelong pursuit for racial equality.